Good day. Today we are going to talk about the arts of India, Pakistan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, and Lebanon. Let us begin. Periods of Indian art. Ancient period, 3900 BCE to 1200 CE. Some evidences of the early civilization are bronze and copper statuettes and steatite seals, which show vigor and concern for surface texture as constantly characterized in Indian art. The Ajanta caves of Maharashtra, India are 30 rock-cut cave monuments that date back from the 2nd century BCE to the 600 CE. Including paintings and sculptures considered to be masterpieces of Buddhist religious art, as well as frescos that are reminiscent of the Sigiriya paintings in Sri Lanka. Classical period, 5th to 6th centuries. The image of Shiva, the destroyer, develops into Shiva the Cosmic Dance, the four-arm figure, where one hand holds the fire with which he destroys, another holds a drum, which is the first sound heard in the world at birth. The third arm points up in a reassuring gesture and a fourth points down to the dwarf in which he dances. Islamic ascendancy, 1192 to 1757, or transitional period. This was the period of evolution from Vedism into Hinduism or Brahmanism. The two great Indian epics, the Mahabharata and the Ramayana, emerged in this period. Mughal period, 16th century, Mughals contributed to the enrichment of Indian culture, in painting and in architecture. The most splendid example is the Taj Mahal, built in 1632 by Shah Jahan in memory of his wife. For comparison purposes, we have India again. The diyas, clay lamps lit during festival of lights or Diwali. And the purpose of this is to persuade Lakshmi, goddess of wealth, into their home. In Pakistan they have truck art, brightly painted trucks making their roads a wall-less gallery or museum. This represents the truck owners and painters' dreams. In Uzbekistan, they have manually made textile products. These are printed tablecloth, curtains, bedspreads, shawls and coverlet. It is used for utilitarian and daily round ornament as well. In Kazakhstan, they have tush kies. It is a large elaborately embroidered wall hangings made of felt. This is a symbol commemorating the marriage of a son or daughter. In Kyrgyzstan, they have shirdaks. It is a handmade carpets or rugs present mostly in all houses or yurts. The design signifies things like circle for the world we live in and spirals for water. In Turkmenistan, they have kitini, homespun silk used by women for their beautiful dresses. The designs are symbols unique to every family as a seal. In Tajikistan, fabrics, utensils, musical inst, carpets, furniture and jewelries, fine carvings. This is a centuries-old industry. Symbolize pride for the artists. In Syria and Lebanon, they have embroidery, ceramics, metalwork and handmade soap and pottery. The pottery is a struggling centuries-old industry in Lebanon. They believe for its use as good for the health. That's all for today and thank you. God bless.